see on Instagram and Facebook. If you are using Instagram and Facebook, this is the most consumed platform. All we did was, when we were marketing for Coffee with Karan, we pre-recorded these four questions with Karan and created an augmented reality integration with Facebook, and people could come out with their stories, their camera came live, and you know, Karan asked the questions and then she answered in the rapid fire way, which is the most popular section. And what you see in her hand is a coffee mug. By the way, it's not a mug, it's actually a AR mug, which means it doesn't exist. After she answered the questions, she just pointed her finger to the camera and the AR mug came alive and she took a picture of that. So when you are able to create 3D graphics and integrate it seamlessly into augmented reality, this is sort of magic that can potentially happen. Again, when I say innovating on a particular format, this is for those who are used to seeing the Instagram feeds. You'll know that this almost seems like there's something wrong with this, because you know, the water is flowing from the top feed to the bottom feed. So you know, you're sort of surprising people on their existing UI. Here's another very interesting, simple but interesting example is, I'm going a little bit into detail on the importance of using the features that are already available within the social media environment. So on Instagram, you have something called wish list, right? So when you like something that you're scrolling, you simply go and say wish list. Then after a while, you can go back to the wish list section and you'll have all those things that you've liked appear in a grid on the wish list. So for McDonald's, what we did was, people were anyway engaging with us, so we said find your heart again, and all they had to do is sequentially, you know, it was sort of a jumbled grid that we gave them, sequentially they had to go and mark it as wish list. So if they missed the sequence, then this heart won't be formed. You know, so it's a very simple exercise using a feature of wish list and how a brand can create engagement. So again, you know, when you have your new collections launching and you want to create interest for your new collection, just jumble up the collection, just don't launch the visual as is. You get people to engage with you through this. This is again popular UI, like whether it is this UI or what you see as your, you know, phone pay, you would end up seeing many UI that you are very familiar with. So this is a great way to incept the brand message as well. Now this is again a lubricant brand that we are working with. It's just a simple creative. If you see, we are saying this is the best product for your buy, accept or reject. You know, so automatically your thumb would go to want to click on the green button, and in a way at the subliminal level you are incepting that this is a good product for your brand. Right, so for Flipkart, again when I say design for action, not sure how many of you know that Flipkart has also started something called Flipkart Video. So if you have Flipkart apps on your phone right now, you'll see that there a video icon has come up at the right bottom. Most people are not aware of this. So we created an entire campaign where we said, Vicky, for example, this is where the content is. So Vicky sperm donate kar raha hai, niche se right dekh. You know, so the entire campaign was around how to get people to see niche se right and then go back on the app and get action out of them. It's a little strange to be showing this creative, you know, in a sort of a jewelry exhibitor's environment, but it's one of my favorite examples, because today we shoot video ads for our consumers, but nothing like making it interactive for your consumer within his social media environment, right? So Halloween, for Z5, we created a video which people could interact with on their stories as a platform. Again, only and only using the existing features of platforms like Facebook and Instagram. So again, people who are familiar with using these platforms would know that I have actions like swipe, tap, you know, these are the things that I anyway do when I use my Instagram or Facebook. So for Halloween, we made people a part of our story in this way. Entire store is visible and checkout is available within the Facebook environment. Similarly on Instagram, this is what you can do right now to inspire you to buy. based on the data that you can provide to the chatbot, it's recommending or throwing products at you. So Facebook bot, you know, all those audiences that you have on your Facebook page today or even Instagram page today, just through a simple chatbot and, you know, a very, very fruitful and valuable engagement can start to happen. So one of our companies, again, partner companies, has taken conversational commerce to the next level, which means that simply by using a certain hashtag. So let's say that you see a product on your feed and you say, I love, hashtag I love. That's what you're putting in the comments. The moment you put hashtag I love, it pops up a chatbot for you. And then you can interact with the chatbot. It will ask you a few questions, you can give it details, and then it will recommend the product to you, and you can actually check out straight from the Facebook environment. And this can be enabled not just on Facebook bot, it can be enabled on any regular chatbot, including iMessages. So, and it can even sort of be activated if you use hashtag within blogs. So anywhere I use a hashtag, it considers this as an intent to buy, and it pops up a chatbot for me to interact with. Available for all of us, all the marketers. All you need to do is create the 3D graphics, and once these graphics are created, you can upload this onto Facebook and Instagram, and people can engage exactly in this way when they look at themselves through the camera. Early 19, we evaluated, as Dvio, we evaluated over 30 campaigns that were run by us in India, Middle East, and Southeast Asia. And what we did was we created a model called the authenticity meter, where one is the least effective when you use, you know, on grade one is the least effective of using an influencer, and six is the highest in terms of the rating when you use the influencer. So just sort of go through this grade of 1 to 6. When you use an influencer purely as a media channel, and he has nothing to do with your brand, right? You just want your brand to reach more and more people. Sometimes celebrities are used like that, right? So that's at 1, because it creates no engagement with the user. Hypothesis also is that if you go with a smaller, if you go with an influencer who has a more intimate set of audience, the credibility of your brand is higher. Then at 2 is, for example, you're using it for reach, but the influencer also sort of echoes the brand ethos and has an audience who understands your brand, or, you know, sort of there's an alignment there. And point 4, if you see, is an interesting point where typically you are likely to go to lifestyle influencers, right? You're likely to go as a dweller, you're likely to go to lifestyle influencers, maybe celebrities. Very interestingly, we've observed the effectiveness is really high when the influencer has nothing to do with your industry, right? So, like, for example, he's a chef influencer who's sort of maybe talking about health food, and what you know about his lifestyle, because he posts on Instagram very regularly, that he's also a cycling enthusiast. So when a cycling brand actually ties up with a chef who is an influencer, the effectiveness of that sort of a collaboration is much higher. And then at 0.5 and 6, we are really talking about not needing an influencer, where we are saying that when the person is, you know, he loves your brand so much that he advocates for your brand without having to really be asked to advocate for your brand. And 6 is when your brand has reached a point where without you orchestrating anything, people are already they're finding communities to sort of come together and posting content about your brand. So for any brand, even if it is local, even if it's sort of really small, the ideal place to be in as far as to be best used when you have a product launch and you want to really reach a lot of audience, but just make sure that the audience of that particular influencer has a direct connect with your brand ethos. So this is a couple of examples on what we did for a brand called Naturalizer in UAE. It's a footwear brand, and it's very, very well known for style and comfort. All we did was we went back to our own social media channels. We saw who is our most engaged audience. We picked 3 women. One was a business coach and a mother. The other was a pregnant woman. They were already engaging with us on our social media platform. So we created a grid and we built stories around all of these guys on why they actually like to be in Naturalizer as they go through their day. And this, in fact, was one of them. And we wanted to create a lot of content with who we call as tier 2 bloggers, right, or tier 2 influencers. You know, you can't always go to the macro influencers. You come to tier 2 bloggers. And we just did this, in fact. We took them to a resort for a high tea, and we gave them a lot of accessories to sort of play with, almost. And we just had a photographer tail them and take pictures as they tried on the accessories and, you know, took selfies and posted on their respective pages. And gave us a few thousand pictures for the brand to use on social media platforms. Plus, it created a really nice mood film like this. The first link that appears when, you know, people search for your category or your brand is not enough. What is important is that the moment you type a set of questions or a set of keywords, you have something called knowledge panel that comes up. So whether your brand is optimized for knowledge panel. So you see the search over here has been iPhone 11 in Dubai, for example. And you know, you see one of our brand's link come up as a knowledge panel because it gave the most authentic and credible information for that particular set of keywords. Happen through voice.
Here's a summary from Gaia.
And again, this is one of our brands where we have optimized for anything to do with Granulabad. Go and search on voice. It will show you results like this. So more and more, in fact, the brands can receive is quite phenomenal. The long-term strategy for any e-commerce player or online salesperson should be to create organic traffic, because that's the only sustainable way to make sure that it's a profitable proposition. So creating content and conversational content, and also optimizing for new technologies.